Stand by. 60 seconds to air.
Standing by.
Activate ERS. Global Radio Network Power Grid. Initiating power up sequence.
ERS Global Radio Network coming online. Transmitter at 50%.
Commence affiliate uplink protocol. Establishing uplink. Connection established. The United States is now online. Canadian uplink connection established. United Kingdom uplink secure. Australia is now online. Slovakia online. South Africa is connected and online. ERS Global Radio Network is online.
Transmitter at maximum. Peak power is established and stable.
Microphones and headphones at full volume.
The Electric Radio Show is now on the air.
You're damn right we are.
All right. Yeah.
How's everything going, everyone? Welcome to another jam-packed Electric Radio Show. We're minus one castmate this time around. Andre, this poor guy cannot get a break. He is under the weather again.
Yeah, well, at least he's not going to get us sick this time.
Yeah, he's not going to get anybody sick, man. Like, he hit me up days ago, man. He said, like, dude, he said, I'm really not feeling well. So, besides, man, I can't tell you how many morning shows I did when I had 103 fever. It's just not fun.
No.
It's not fun. And he has no voice.
Mm.
So there's no point in even coming to the studio.
That's right.
I mean, he's beyond the infectious stage. Now he's just got the annoying I have no voice. Why bother, man? Stay in bed. Have a couple of drinks. I know some really good bourbon that'll bring your voice back.
That's right. That's
and your sense of humor.
That's right.
Coming up on the big show this time around, we're playing a game.
Oh, yes,
we are. We haven't played Factor Bullcrap in such a long time. Don't worry, Dee Lite's looking for pen and paper.
I got it already.
I got you covered, too. Okay. So covering Andre's stories this time around will be Dee Lite.
Oh, awesome.
Dee Lite's got one coming up. She doesn't let me see these at all, so she's got one coming up called Ringing My Taco Bell. I don't know what that's all about. I got one. Here comes the bride and the bill. You guys know what weddings cost nowadays?
A lot.
Ridiculous.
Especially
ridiculous.
You suckers out there that got engaged on Valentine's Day. Nah, you're not suckers. But I'm going to give you a little hint on what your wedding could possibly cost you. Coming up in the Underground Spotlight, great band. We got them all. They're all great. The name of the group is Reason Define, and the name of the tune is called Pointing Fingers. It's kind of like this one.
Not, not a good place to point it.
I'll tell you what, up to the first knuckle, you're fine.
Oh, wow.
Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Maniac, is here and covering her regular duties. Dee Lite will give you the Hollywood Hotwire. Clay Johnson with the headlines is on the way. What do you think of his new music, by the way?
I like it.
It's slamming.
I like it.
I gotta give these guys props, man, because I use their music a lot. The name of this, they're like DJs, a group, or it's all like electronic music. The name of this group is Knife Party.
Okay.
And the name of this song that it's looped out at is called Give It Up. You've got to look these guys up on YouTube.
Definitely. The music
is sick. I have these guys cranking in my car all the time. So, Knife Party. Thank you for putting together some great stuff, man. So this is Knife Party's Give It Up. You guys, give it up. Don't try to run away. Strap in, buckle up, cinch them up tight. You're getting ready for the thrill ride that we call the Electric Radio Show. Take us out, Knife Party.
I was listening to the broadcast. I was wondering, what exactly is it?
This show will have laughter, tears,
topless arguments, infections caused by jacuzzi water.
It's really weird.
It's about to get a whole lot weirder.
It's showtime.
Time for my favorite show.
Is it on now?
What time is that show again?
It's on now.
For real?
For real.
And we're on it now.
Okay, here we go.
All right, it's showtime.
The Electric Radio Show. We have wires. We have electricity. Don't get us wet.
You guys are so sexy and funny. Oh, here's your coffee.
Have a great show.
You're listening to The Electric Radio Show.
It's The Electric Radio Show. Time to give you a peek into our sometimes exciting, but mostly humdrum lives in our segment that we call What's Up. I'm going to start with Andre. What's up? All right, cool. Air break is nuts, man. Dee Lite, what's up?
Can I just tell you, I hate first dates. I hate them. I hate them with a passion.
Did you have a Valentine's first date?
It actually wasn't Valentine's. It was Valentine's weekend, you know, the weekend after that.
Oh, okay. So you didn't go out on Valentine's Day.
No, 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 no.
That's cool.
But
because that means commitment, by the way.
No, and you know how I feel about that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But here's the thing, okay? So, nice guy, okay? He said to me to pick a place for us to go have some dinner. There's a Mexican restaurant not far from here, not far from the studio.
Oh, the one up the street?
Yeah.
The new place?
I've never been there. So I pass by it every time I come to the studio. I've never been there. So I said, well, let's go there. Okay. So.
All right.
By all accounts, I've heard the place is great. Okay. The service was abysmal.
Wow.
It was really bad.
Oh,
and the thing is,
they didn't like pour soup on you or anything.
No, but I almost had dessert flipped on me.
Wow.
So, you know, we go to this nice Mexican restaurant, okay? And it's early because I wanted to go early because I am not one of these people that likes to eat at 9 o'clock at night. Okay.
Yeah,
I like to eat at like 5. Okay.
Okay.
So it was early and it was not crowded yet at all. So we walk in and they're like, okay, just give us a minute. And we sat there. And like 15 minutes later, they finally seat us. And I'm thinking to myself,
was there people in front of you?
No, there was nobody. Okay. Because it wasn't.
You're just getting all worked up, Gil.
Yeah.
I know.
You hear the tone in the voice?
I know.
The tonality.
We finally sit down. We place our orders. I ordered some kind of combo. It was a chimichanga and an enchilada.
Ooh,
okay.
I take that right now.
Oh, as hungry as I am. Absolutely.
Wait. Okay. Uh-oh. So the food comes out, and on the plate in front of me is clearly a chimichanga and an enchilada. I start to eat it. The waitress comes up to me and she's like, wait, that's not your meal.
Oh, wait, don't eat that, man.
Yeah, I'm like, well, it looks like my meal. I'm like, it tastes good. I'll just keep it. And she's like, no, it belongs to somebody else. She takes it.
She took your plate that you already ate off of?
And she puts it down on somebody else's table.
Oh,
and I'm like yelling across the restaurant. I'm like, I ate off that already. Okay.
So and now you don't want it back because it's been on somebody else's table that they could have inadvertently like put spittle in your food.
So they bring me out another plate. But this isn't what I ordered. And I'm like, all right, fine, I'll just eat this.
Wow.
So my poor date, he's like just sitting there and all right, so I kind of am like a take charge kind of girl. I think
you guys
know that, all right?
No.
No.
Yeah.
Not really.
So he's just sitting there. I don't think he knows how to respond. And so they bring us dessert and the kid drops the dessert on me, all right? And I'm just like, I'm done.
Are these people drunk?
No, and I just don't understand how.
I want to cut to the chase.
Yeah.
How was the food?
The food was really good. I cannot take that away from them.
All right.
Okay.
So, I mean, I don't mind having a plate of dessert spilled on me as long as I can lick it off myself.
Exactly.
You know, if you spill it on my ass and I can't get to it, I'm pissed.
On my arm, I'm fine. The service was just so bad.
That's
and I
right.
felt bad because my date felt bad. He was uncomfortable. I was uncomfortable. Oh, yeah. I don't think that's going to happen again.
All right. So your what's up is going to be soused of the border.
Oh, yeah.
You.
Well, my what's up is a unique one because I have a beautiful partner, and I love her to death. And she's got the weirdest excitement factors.
All right.
Okay. So, there's a rule. You never buy your partner, your wife, whoever it is, you never buy her an appliance for a holiday.
Sure.
Or a break.
Right.
Because absolutely.
That's, that's like...
Or clothes.
Right. That's like the worst thing to do.
Right.
Well, Valentine's Day passed. I got her something. You know, even though I'm not a big proponent of... Well, okay, fine. I got her something for that. But today, I bought her a vacuum cleaner, and she was more excited about that. and thanked me and started doing the happy dance to the whole house.
Over a vacuum.
Over a vacuum cleaner.
Yeah, you just can't give it for Valentine's Day.
Right, which I understand that. And I made sure I didn't do that. But it just blew my mind at how humble she is and how grateful she is about things. But also, it blew my mind about how excited she got over a vacuum cleaner.
There's two choices that we can give you. Do you ever see the movie Earth, Girls Are Easy?
Remember, oh, yeah.
Remember that? Yes. I remember that one.
Your title could be Q's Wife is Easy.
No.
Or Your Gift Sucks.
Either one works.
So you guys out there can take your choice on that. My what's up is, listen, my birthday's coming up.
Oh, geez.
And it's like, I'm going to make this almost nearly a month-long celebration.
Of course you should.
All right? And it's not to give presents to me. Okay? What I did, and I've never done, I've done plenty of charity work in 30 years of radio.
Right.
I mean, Hugh knows it.
Yes.
Dee knows some of the work I've done. I mean, I've done everything for, food pantries, soup kitchens, mm-hmm. toy drives, collecting money in the snow and all this stuff. And I've never done one of these before. And I decided like 30 minutes before we hit air to do this. Facebook has fundraisers that you can do for your birthday.
Mm. Oh, that's right. Yeah, yes.
I decided to do a fundraiser for my birthday. I'm not in the best party mode right now, and everybody knows why.
Right.
Out there. Go to facebook.com/therealjackhammer, or else you're going to have to look for Hammer Jack, because Facebook says Jack Hammer is porn. But that's a story for another What's Up, and a totally different What's Up. But if you go there, I have a fundraiser going right now, and it's going through the 15th of March. They let me set the parameters.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to set this thing up through the 15th, through the middle of the month. And the fundraiser is for Take Me Home Pet Rescue Incorporated, and they're in Highland, New York.
Okay.
And I'm going to tell you why. These people started this organization. And I'm not mentioning any names because I haven't even really reached out to them yet. I just decided to do it for them. So I'm not mentioning any names. But I will tell you this. The vast majority of the funds that run this organization is their own money.
Mm-hmm.
And they're rescuing animals not just from this area. I mean, they're going down to Tennessee, North Carolina. They're going to get them. And then they have these caravans that they meet where people bring these animals from kill shelters and animals that were in abusive situations or maybe were displaced through natural disasters and stuff. These people could really use the help. So that's what I decided to do. And I did it in honor of Sonny and Bridget's memory.
Okay.
Well, I have to tell you something. Have you looked at your page lately?
No.
You're going to have to increase the parameters.
All right. Maybe. I'll have to look. I'll have to look. But
because 25% of your donation goal is already achieved.
Well, look at that, man. How about it? How about that?
All right.
How about that? Well, folks, I set a reasonable goal. I set like a $200 goal.
Hey, very reasonable.
And I'm going to tell you right now, kick this thing into high gear. We're on 65, 60, I don't even know. Six countries, seven countries. It's all in U.S. dollars. Convert the currency. Get the money to these people. They can really use it.
Yeah.
So my what's up is, I don't know. If you want to give me a present, donate to Take Me Home. That's my what's up. Facebook.com/TheRealJackHammer. Go there, donate. And they actually have predetermined amounts. And if you don't have that amount, click other.
Right.
Give whatever you can.
Right.
It'll help out.
Listen, if our affiliates just give $3 each station, you've achieved your goal.
There you go. Come on, affiliates. Come on. We love you. Help us out with this.
Absolutely.
So that's what's coming up. Coming up straight ahead with the news, the headlines, our new news guy, Clay Johnson, is straight ahead on the Electric Radio Show.
I think today at home. Stay. go to work when it is such a lovely day. I'll call my boss, pretend to cough, and if he buys the story, I've got the whole day off.
Hello?
I just called to say I'm real sick. I just called to say I've got the flu. I just called to say I can't make it in. Okay, bye. Now it looks like I got the whole day to goof off.
The Electric Radio Show.
Yeah, it gets me in the zone. Keeps like it kind of like tunes everything else out for me.
The hottest radio show on the planet.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Let's take a look at the headlines. With all the news, it is the news. Wouldn't be the news without him. Here's the news guy from the newsroom, Clay Johnson.
This is Clay Johnson with an Electric Radio Show news brief. Both Kamala Harris and Amy Klobuchar have been getting advice from Hillary Clinton on their 2020 presidential campaigns. Harris and Klobuchar plan to listen to what Hillary Clinton has to say and then do the exact opposite. Authorities in Canada are baffled after finding the 15th severed foot on the Vancouver shoreline in a decade. They should just look for people who can't stop swimming in circles and ask them what happened.
Oh.
Utah is trying to redesign the state flag to better represent its citizens. So expect the new design to consist of a giant slice of Wonder Bread. Ford will invest $1 billion in Chicago. Residents jump for joy and were promptly cut down by automatic gunfire. YouTube announced it will no longer recommend conspiracy theory videos. I can't be sure, but I have a feeling the lizard people are behind this. In related news, legendary conspiracy theorist Lyndon LaRochelle Jr. has died at the age of 96. Or has he? A spokesperson for Bill Cosby said Cosby is not remorseful because he's done nothing wrong. That's really sad. I'm talking about being a spokesperson for Bill Cosby. Jennifer Lopez plays a stripper in her upcoming movie. Nothing else is known about the movie at this time except that I will be in the front row on opening night. And finally, the trailer for Shaft is out. And here's the shocking thing. It doesn't star Jeff Bezos' junk. This is Clay Johnson with an Electric Radio Show news trip.
Coming up in just a couple of minutes, Dee Lite ringing my Taco Bell on the Electric Radio Show.
Let me see what you can do.
You're listening to the Electric Radio Show.
On air.
And that's just and how we do it.
Online. TheElectricRadioShow.com.
Feel the power.
These days, it seems everyone in the country is worried about healthcare, expensive premiums, complicated plans. So here at this station, we've come up with a simple one-step solution to everyone's healthcare woes. And our plan is just three words long. Don't get sick. For example, if you're out in public, avoid airborne diseases by not breathing. In fact, don't go out in public at all. It's full of sick people. That way you won't be driving, so no more traffic accidents. And at home, avoid injuries that could lead to hospitalization. Don't take showers. They're too slippery. And avoid the dangers of choking by not eating food. In fact, the only thing absolutely safe for you to do is listen to this show. Afraid you'll lose coverage? Don't have any? Don't worry. Just don't get sick. It really is that simple. Plus, your new plan can start now, and it's free.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Dee Lite's got a story called Ringin' My Taco Bell. Mm. Cue the Ringin' My Taco Bell music.
All right, so Kelly Stewart, a 27-year-old woman who works at a Taco Bell in upstate New York, has taken her role at this fast food restaurant and used it to brighten customers' days.
Huh.
Kelly has been writing inspirational messages, and she puts them inside every bag.
Wow. Really? She's handwriting these messages?
Yeah. So Kelly started working at the Taco Bell in Syracuse, New York last fall, and she said, quote, I enjoy people. I like helping them make each day better, and it's important for me to set a good example for my 6-year-old son. Sometimes life can be tough, and I like looking up quotes and writing them out for people. So that's pretty cool, huh?
Wow.
That is
See,
nice.
Now, I told you about my experience with Taco Bell close to here. I said that the restaurant is not only clean as clean can be, that the service was outstanding.
Right. You did say that, yeah.
Yeah. So the idea first came to her when her coworkers, whom she refers to as one big family, were required to add a promotional survey receipt into each order. Kelly noticed that there was a small blank spot on the back of the survey, perfect for what she calls an inspirational pick-me-up.
Nice.
Customers have noticed this simple act of kindness and have begun sharing the messages they received from her on social media. Kelly said, I may just work at a fast food place, but you have to take pride in what you do, especially with how hard today's times are. It's nice to put a smile on someone's face.
Oh, man. That is awesome. That is totally awesome. And I love it when people just take it upon themselves to do something nice, not go running to, you know, someone that could potentially turn around and say, well, if you put something nice in there, they may take offense to that. You know there's going to be that one manager out there.
Of course there is. Of course
there
is.
That's a total tool bag that would stop her from doing it. But, all right.
Yeah.
All right. Hands up. That's right.
What's her name again?
Her name is Kelly Stewart.
Kelly Stewart, you are the official Electric Radio Show hero of the episode. So there you go.
All right.
There you go. Coming up in just a little bit, group in the Underground Spotlight. Give it a listen. It's a great tune. The name of the group, Reason Defined. They're pointing fingers. Coming up next on the Electric Radio Show.
I am just sick to my stomach this morning.
Sometimes you just make me sick to my stomach.
You make me physically sick to my stomach.
Why not call in sick then?
I'm sick today and I can't come to work.
Weak, convenient excuse.
Who's the replacement? The Cut Man.
The Cut Man?
The Cut Man.
Could you repeat that last part?
Are you awake?
Yeah.
What day is that?
Throwback Thursday.
Throwback.
Throwback.
Throwback Thursday.
A bit of a throwback.
You know, throwback.
Thursday.
What does that mean?
It's more fun.
Oh, okay.
It's Thursday and tomorrow's Friday.
Come on, start this thing.
Let's put on a show.
Let's make it our best show ever.
What is this?
Showtime. Drama queen.
Drama queen.
Drama queen? You're the drama queen, mister.
Drama and education. This show has everything.
All right, guys, let's focus up.
For God's sake, straighten your tie. This isn't a tractor pull.
Ah, oh, so happy. I can't even feel my arms.
Live! From the radio station with more listeners than your mother's 1-900 number. Here's the show that starts one half hour before Zero Dark 30. Proud owners of the entire Dejanga action figure collection. The show that's more fun than a barrel full of Al Roker's White House poo-poo undies.
You know, that is really getting annoying.
Everybody love everybody!
It's the Electric Radio Show.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, yeah,
right,
baby.
Yes, sir.
Coming up in a little bit in the Underground Spotlight, as I said, the group Reason Defined with pointing fingers. Dee Lite's got her little Hollywood Hotwire fingers all ready to go. We'll give you the lowdown in Tinseltown. And I got a story for you people that might have gotten engaged on Valentine's Day, which is a beautiful thing. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying anything wrong about it. But I got a story called Here Comes the Bride and the Bill. I'm going to let you know what it could potentially set mom and dad back. Maybe almost as much as your college education.
That's just stupid.
It's crazy. I'm telling you, when you hear these, when I read this story, I could not believe the numbers I was reading. And by the way, I'll give you some of them by location. So that's all coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
This is breaking news.
This just in. 63% of the 84% of people surveyed say 34% of people believe 57% of percentage surveys are confusing.
This has been breaking news.
It pumps me up. It makes me happier. It makes me dance. Makes people laugh at me while I'm dancing when they walk in. But I do it.
If it's upbeat, it gives me energy.
We love this show.
The Electric Radio Show.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Time to fire up that underground spotlight. Dee Lite, throw the switch. I'm holding on.
Ready?
Yep.
There you go.
Get over the other one.
Wait, you're going to knock everything off.
Wow. We got to get those wires moved from that one. Wow. It's a little tense. The underground spotlight is lit, and that puts you guys out there in the spotlight. If you're a musician, a band, an artist, an author, a filmmaker, you guys want some love for your project, all you have to do is go to theelectricradioshow.com and click the banner for the underground spotlight. Just like Reason to Find. Check this tune out. It's called Pointing Fingers from the Underground Spotlight, featured artist of the week, Reason to Find, on the Electric Radio Show.
Yeah.
in. There you go.
All right. That was
good. There's a reason to find right there.
There you go.
Great tune. Once again, that's called Pointing Fingers from Reason to Find. And one more time, if you want to get your project some love, simply go to theelectricradioshow.com, click the banner for the Underground Spotlight, fill out all the details. Who knows? You can be coming up on the next Electric Radio Show. And please, please, when it comes to music, it's got to be radio friendly. No cursing, no filth. You're out of the running at that point. It's got to be radio friendly.
That's right.
Two, we're not buying your project. So don't tell me for, $450,000 I have a copy of your film, because that one gets a laugh and a delete.
That's right.
See how that works? All you got to do is just get us a copy of whatever you're pimping. We'll hook you up. Coming up, here comes the bride and the bill. You're going to find out what some of these weddings are costing and some of the locations. Coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
Hello?
Boss, I can't make it in. I'm sick.
What do you have this time?
I have,
Sound familiar? Each and every day, millions of lazy Americans can't decide what to tell their boss when they call in sick. Finally, there's an answer.
Thank you for coming in to Calling In Sick Excuse Consultants. How may I be of assistance?
I don't feel like going to work, and I'm starting to run out of bogus medical ailments.
Have you considered Hong Kong flu?
Hey, thanks.
Whether you want to tell your boss your scarlet rubella's acting up again, or that you've just got another touch of hoof and mouth disease, Calling In Sick Excuse Consultants has the fib that's right for you.
Hello?
Boss, I can't make it in. I'm sick.
Again? What is it this time?
Bubonic plague.
You know, Winthorpe had that last week. It must be going around.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Now, some of you out there may be inquisitive, saying, well, how come he's not playing Here Comes the Bride?
Because some of the prices on these weddings, Tony Soprano can afford.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you mean.
All right. From The Knot, as the publication, The Knot just released its annual Real Wedding Study, which found that the average wedding in America last year cost a whopping $33,931.
Actually, that's better than I thought it was going to be.
Well, check it out. That's only $600 more than 2017, but down about $1,400 from 2 years ago.
Wow.
Manhattan. That would be New York, New York, was by far the most expensive place to get married. At just under, on average, just under 97 Gs.
Wow.
Stupid.
For me, it's dropping the bucket. Sill, do me a favor. Go in a blue suit. Get the 97.
Long Island, also in New York, is next at $66,409 to be married on the island of Long. Then in Chicago, they were about $60,000. No bulletproof vest, as far as I know. And at the other end of the spectrum, you get married in Idaho, cost you about $16,366.
But you got a nice view of the Rocky Mountains, don't you?
I think so. You could be right. I have no idea. Or the Idaho Mountains.
There's Idaho Mountains.
Yeah. You know, here's a breakdown of the cost, and it's what the average couple spent last year. The average wedding dress was about $1,631 compared to just $283 for the groom's outfit. The wedding photographer, get this, more than the wedding dress, $2,700. Wow. The wedding band, $4,247. The DJ, where the hell were these numbers when I was DJing weddings? $1,292 for the DJ. Flowers. The flowers, $2,411. The liquor, kind of on the cheap end. Me, I thought that would have been $4,247, but it's not. It's $2,564. And the food, about $70 a guest. That's what it costs. The average bridesmaid dress, about $142. Wedding cake, $528. Rehearsal dinner, $1,297 for a rehearsal dinner?
Yeah, because you're bringing the whole both parties and you got to feed everybody.
Damn. Man, now you've been going to Taco Bell with me.
That's right.
The average reception venue was this insane $15,439.
Yep, that's about right.
Un-freaking believable. There's about five more stats in this thing for the average wedding. I just can't. I can't even go any further than that. It's sick.
If I ever get married, I'm just going to Vegas and just doing it
this
there.
This is what I'm saying. And enjoy the vacation. Pay the vacation. Oh, take that money and buy a house with it. Yeah, you know, put crazy. It as a down payment.
Can I tell you something? My wife and I, we didn't elope. We told the family we're going to go to Las Vegas and we're going to get married. It was just the two of us. And right. We didn't do like the drive-through chapel crap. We got married at the Excalibur Hotel, which is right next door to the Luxor. We stayed at the Luxor, got married at the Excalibur. It was just the two of us.
Mm-hmm.
They put us in like the Sistine Chapel. I mean, it was a gigantic chapel.
How much did it cost you?
I don't even remember. It wasn't that much. It honestly wasn't that much. I don't even remember.
What, like a couple $100?
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't bad. They had a small chapel and a big chapel.
Okay.
And I said, well, give us the small chapel. I mean, that's fine. We're good with that. And they're like, oh, no. You can have the big chapel. I'm like, no, we would, you know. Dude, this is such a long story. It would go past the length and duration of this bit. But let me tell you, it's comical. One day, I'll tell all you guys out there about my wedding day.
Love to hear it.
It was a wedding day story that can only be applied to Jack Hammer.
Of course.
Trust me. So there you go. If you got engaged on Valentine's Day, that's what it could set you back. I hope you just go to Vegas, get married. We had a great time.
It's even cheaper for a trip to Hawaii. Go to Hawaii.
Go to Hawaii, get married, and enjoy the sights.
Exactly.
Coming up, Dee Lite's all set and ready to go to give you the lowdown in Tinseltown. The Hollywood Hotwire is next on the Electric Radio Show.
The flu epidemic is spreading across the United States. But what about you, Mr. Healthy? Everyone else is home watching Netflix, and you're still at work. Just because you haven't gotten the flu yet. Well, now there's InstaFlu. Just leave a voicemail with our subscription service, and we'll computer generate your voice calling in sick.
This is Rick.
Yeah, boss, I I don't think I'll be in today. I think I've got the flu. Oh, hold on.
Ooh, just stay at home. Definitely don't want you here.
InstaFlu for an Insta vacation. See, you're feeling better already. Have a great long weekend.
Just when you thought they've gone too far, they're just getting started. Jack Hammer, Andre Kane, Sacred Owl, and Dee Lite.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Let's see what's going on in the Wood of Holly. It's the Hollywood Hotwire with Dee Lite.
All right, taking a look around the internet for what's trending in Hollywood. Actor William Shatner took the stage for the first time at the Grand Ole Opry to sing his new album of country songs. He released a country album called Why Not Me, which features songs like Beam Me Up, a nod to both whiskey maker Jim Beam and Shatner's catchphrase on the popular sci-fi TV show. The 87-year-old actor told the Associated Press that while he's not a typical singer, he understands the musicality of language. He's released several albums, including Christmas music and rock, and has plans to record a blues album next.
Uh-oh.
What is this? What is the name of this album again that he's coming out with?
The album is called Why Not Me, and one of the songs is called Beam Me Up.
All right. We're going to have to get a copy.
Absolutely, please.
Even if I can get a snippet. All right. You know what? Go ahead, D-Lite. Keep going. I'm going to see if I can have this before you're done.
All right. If you are looking for a cruise that lets you get to dive into one of the most popular 80s sitcoms, you're in luck. Flip Phone Events is organizing a Golden Girls cruise that
will depart
from Miami before making stops at Key West and Cozumel in February of 2020. The sitcom, which took place in Miami, ended in 1992, but it still has a dedicated fan base and has proven to be very popular among millennials. Activities include Golden Girls trivia, a Shady Pines craft corner, Key West Golden Girls bar crawl, Golden Girls costume contest, and a one-night in St. Olaf dance party. The cruise will kick off February 24th, 2020, and tickets will start at $1,000.
Wow.
What the hell? Really?
That's awesome.
All right, hold on.
Hold Did you on. Find it?
I found it. Do we want to hear an excerpt from William Shatner's Beam Me Up?
Sure.
Please do.
All right, hold on. Let me kill the Entertainment Tonight music, and let's go to the videotape that we call the YouTube. Here we go. William Shatner, new release, Beam Me Up with Jeff Cook. Oh, boy.
Oh, geez.
You like country.
I do, but this is going down a bad path.
Beer? No, I'm not feeling it. Wine? Not so much. I'm looking for something a whole lot stronger with a hangover punch. Yeah, she's out of here. Crushed? Only temporarily, thanks to my old faithful friend, Mr. Jim Beam.
Beam me up.
Beam me up.
I'm on a mission. Drown out the pain.
Okay.
I want to boldly go where I know I shouldn't go. So pass the cup and beam me up.
There you go. William Shatner, right. Beam me up, man. I'll tell you, I've personally sat and spoke with William Shatner, man. He's a great cat. He's an awesome dude, man.
All right, so ever wonder who the top earners were for 2018 amongst dead celebrities?
Please.
Amongst any guesses?
Dead celebrities?
You're talking about celebrities?
Go ahead, make a guess.
I got two guesses. Michael Jackson and Elvis Presley.
What do you think?
These are celebrities that have expired.
Yes.
They're no longer here.
They're no longer with us.
That's what expired means, man.
I got to agree with Q. Michael Jackson would be one of them.
All right, you don't get all night. So, all right, let me just get into
the... It's only a few minutes.
So, I've got the top five top-earning dead celebrities of 2018, according to Forbes magazine. Coming in at number five, Bob Marley, $23 million.
I can see that, definitely.
Number four, cartoonist Charles Schultz, brought in $34 million.
Peanuts. Yep.
Number three is pro golfer Arnold Palmer with $35 million.
Really?
Yeah, mm-hmm. He's got a lot of his names out there.
Now,
man.
Here we go. Number two, Elvis Presley with $40 million.
Yep.
Way
he
go,
still
Kill.
Moves more than 1 million albums every year, but the bulk of the King's coin comes from tickets to Graceland and a new $45 million entertainment complex called Elvis Presley's Memphis.
Really?
Wow.
Wow.
And number one, Michael Jackson.
Of course.
He earned $400 million last year. According to Forbes magazine, although Jackson is usually number one on the list this past year, it got boosted even higher thanks to a $287 million earning from the sale of his estate stake in EMI Music Publishing to Sony.
Wow.
What the hell,
wow.
man?
Yeah. The $400 million. There's a big difference between first place and second place there.
Yeah.
And he's making a lot more money than very good actors and actresses.
Yeah, being deceased.
Being deceased.
Yeah.
Wow.
Are Paris and Blanket, and are they his heirs?
I would assume so. I mean, it just says his estate, so I would assume he took care of his
you
children.
You know, do his brothers get any of this?
I don't think so.
You know, Marlon, Tito, Randy.
I don't know.
That's an S load of money.
That is an awful lot of money.
Nothing near my yearly salary.
So that's what's twinkling in Tinseltown this week. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram at The Electric Radio Show.
Have you seen any updates on Ozzy at all?
No, I didn't see anything this week.
His son Jack had posted, I think it was, might have been on Instagram, some that he's doing better or something. I'm really concerned for Ozzy.
I'm not breaking into
an Ozzy bit right now. I'm just legitimately concerned for Ozzy Osbourne. Because I really do, man. I've got this like newfound respect and love for Ozzy Osbourne ever since. And do you know, I was so late with watching the Osbournes. Like the Osbournes had its run and had concluded, and I had never watched the show.
Really?
Once. Yeah, my wife is like, you like Ozzy and you've never watched the Osbournes? And I never did, and I binged it.
I thought the first season was really good, but it was all good. I thought the after season one, they got hip to,
Yeah, well, they had to do what the production company wanted them to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but Ozzy and Jack's World Detour, then I got sucked into that. Another great show.
Mm-hmm.
I really love Ozzy, man, and I just hope he's doing well. So
the current news here is that he had to cancel New Zealand, Australia, and Japanese tours.
Yeah, that
tours.
Was, yeah, that's kind that of expected. Done,
but that's the only news.
But Jack said he's doing good, so
that's good. That's
anybody
good.
Knows Ozzy out there personally, hit us up. Let us know what's going on. StudioERS@gmail.com. On the way, we're going to play around the factor bullcrap. And we got listener email. And Dee Lite's got another delightful story. This one's called, I don't know, Walmart Junk.
Mm-hmm.
Coming up on the Electric Radio Show.
And now, Deep Thoughts with Brian Summers.
Hello, it is Brian Summers. Hold on, excuse me. I have a little bit of a bug today. It is cold and flu season, you know. You caught this yet? Like to send a big thank you out to all the people who like to take their germs with them, scatter them all over everything so Brian gets sick. Thank you very much. I don't like getting sick, do you? First of all, it's very hard to sleep at night, then get up and come into work with a bunch of people who got you sick in the first place. I mean, it's like, oh, you want this when? How about when you get it? How's that? Then I cough on them and they go away. I mean, I don't even like talking to anyone unless, of course, there's some really good, juicy gossip. How many sick days do you get? I only get 5 sick days. 4 of them I normally use because I'm sick of working here. I think I'm gonna take one right now. Just need to sneeze on my boss's door handle before I leave.
This has been Deep Thoughts with Brian Summers.
F you!
Hey!
Sorry!
You're listening to the Electric Radio Show. No saturated fats, no cholesterol, no chlorofluorocarbons, no artificial flavors or artificial colors. Funny how, with all that's going for us, we're still bad for you. The Electric Radio Show.
You're sick, vile, drunken whore.
You're going to get so much acid, it's going to be sick.
It is disgusting enough seeing a woman and a horse do it.
It's disgusting.
I'm giving birth to a food baby.
Disgusting.
If I say it, I'm sick.
For starters, you can wipe that disgusting smirk off your face.
Vile, drunken whore.
It's a shock when you eat vegetables full of vitamins, minerals, and trace amounts of bug feces.
I'm talking like crazy, like boy band ass.
Filthy habit.
I feel like something crawled inside me and took a crap.
I think I can safely say that we all have family issues, work stuff, and or are sick.
Whoa! I think we got a show.
Oh, yeah, we got a show.
We definitely got a show.
Oh, yeah, there's a show.
I wasn't playing with myself in the bathtub. I was just cleaning it, and it went off.
I thought I told you never to interrupt me while I'm working.
Hey! What are you trying to do?
So crazy someplace else. We're all stocked up here.
Don't mess with me. I'm one crazy mofo.
Go ahead. Make my day.
This show sucks.
Well, this whole place sucks. That's right, it sucks.
Due to some content, parental discretion is advised.
I am the thing from Uranus.
You can lose that smart mouth right now.
You just don't get it, do you?
It is a thrill. I love this show.
The dead have risen and are voting Republican.
I'm George W. Bush, and I approve this message.
And I approve the Electric Radio Show.
All right, all right, all right.
We are zooming right along in this episode of the Electric Radio Show. Coming up, we are going to tone things down to get our metaphysic on. Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Maniac, will be here with your weekly astrology. We've got love for you guys for giving us love all week long on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Social shout-outs, listener email on the way. Dee.
Yeah?
Can you give us, like, a little tiny clue what Walmart junk is? Is it, like, clearance items?
I will tell you this. The story is rated PG-13.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, okay. All righty.
Ah.
So if that helps.
All right.
Helps a lot.
So junk may not necessarily be what's on a shelf.
Right.
All right.
I mean, like, you could put it on a shelf, but...
Oh, jeez. Oh, you just said that. I dropped all my paper.
Hold on.
Hate it when that happens.
Does it come with pictures? You know, I'm just...
Oh, and pictures are involved.
Oh, boy.
Jeez.
Oh, boy.
Coming up straight ahead, get your thinking caps on. We're going to play a round of Factor Bullcrap on the Electric Radio Show.
Like working, rather be at home, not
if our music were clothes, the Electric Radio Show would be butt naked.
Ooh, it's all I listen to.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Let's play a game. Cue the Factor bullcrap music. All right. So recently was President's Day.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So why not do a theme? How about civics? Civics.
What? What do you mean civics?
Check this out. A new study found that only one in four Americans could pass the U.S. citizenship test.
Oh, okay.
Which requires a 60 to pass. So if you can get at least three of these five sample questions right, you could be a U.S. citizen, or you might be a dumbass.
All right, well, we're not going to get deported or anything if we don't, right?
I don't know. I might build a wall around you. Why are you putting your hood up, Q?
Yeah, it's my thinking cap.
Oh, it's your thinking cap? Yeah, you just don't want to be seen here.
Yeah, well, it's my thinking cap.
All right, it's real simple. I'm going to ask you five questions. It's either yes, fact, or no bullcrap, okay? Question one, U.S. citizenship test practice question.
This is a practice question?
Yeah, a sample question. That's what it's called, sample question.
So we're doing a sample question and then the real question?
No. These are sample questions. Try to keep up. Question one, the president is in charge of the government's executive branch. Fact or bullcrap, Dee Lite?
Fact.
Q.
Fact.
It is a fact. Normally, Andre's here to go, everybody said fact. I think I should say bullcrap.
I know, right?
I love Andre. I miss you, dude. Get better. Come back. It is a fact. There are three branches of government. The president runs the executive. Congress runs which branch, Dee?
Legislative.
And what does the court run?
Judicial.
There you go. Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding, woo! Ding.
I need my bell when we play a game.
If you asked me, I'd have been deported.
Build a wall around you.
Build a wall around me.
Question two, U.S. citizenship test factor bullcrap. The first 10 amendments to the Constitution are called the Bill of Rights. Factor bullcrap, Dee Lite.
Wait, so repeat the question?
The first 10 amendments to the Constitution are called the Bill of Rights. Factor bullcrap.
Bullcrap.
Q.
Fact.
It is a fact. It is a fact. They were all ratified at the same time in 1791. Question three. A total of 24 amendments to the Constitution have been passed so far. A total of 24 amendments to the Constitution.
Is that fact or bullcrap? Is that the question?
Have been passed so far. Fact or bullcrap?
Fact?
Fact.
It is bullcrap. The correct answer is 27. The last one was passed in 1992.
It's not looking good for me.
It changed the law so if U.S. Congress can up their own salary.
Oh, that's nice.
That's nice. It doesn't take effect until after the next election, though. Number four, factor bullcrap, U.S. citizenship test. There are a total of 435 voting members in the House of Representatives. There are 435 voting members in the House of Representatives. Fact or bullcrap, Dila?
Fact.
Q.
Bullcrap.
No, it's a fact. There are 535 total members of Congress, 435 in the House of Reps, and 100 senators. What's the score, Delight?
We're tied. 2 apiece.
All right.
Really? You both got 2 apiece?
Yep.
All right. This is the tie-breaking question. Somebody's going to win, or it's nude Greco-Roman wrestling on the floor between Sacred Owl and Delight substitute Andre Kane next week.
So. All right.
Fifth and final question. The Constitution was written in 1787. Dee Lite.
I will say fact.
Q.
I think that's bullcrap.
No, it's a fact.
Okay.
The Constitution was written in 1787. The Declaration of Independence was written in 1776 by Thomas Jefferson. The Constitution was not for another 11 years. What do we got? Who is the winner?
I'm the winner. I have 3, and Sacred Owl has 2.
Build a wall around me.
Build a wall around me. Can we get Q deported, please?
Yes.
I got 60%, so I can stay.
You got the 60.
Well, actually, no. There was what, 4 questions?
No, 5.
Oh, all right.
You needed 3 out of 5
to
stay.
Yep, I'm good. I'm staying.
And Q, you only got 2?
Yeah.
We'll give you a green card, work card, visa.
That's fine. No problem. You know.
Yeah, you can clean the studio after we're done.
That's not
did
nice.
Did he really go there? What an ass. There. What a jackass. That's all I got to say. On the way, listener email coming up. And Walmart junk rated PG-13. You might want to check the kitties on this one. That's all coming up on the Electric Radio Show. I love you, Q.
I love you too, guys.
TrickRadioShow.com.
It's the Electric Radio Show. All right, this is the time of the show where you may want to get the kitties away from the radio, or let them stay.
Well, I thought that was done 2 hours ago.
Pretty much. Dee, what do you got?
All right, so a 60-year-old Utah man is charged with illegal pornography distribution after leaving a picture of his erect penis under the door handle of a woman's car in the parking lot of a Walmart in Layton, Utah.
In Utah?
In Utah.
So Timothy James Odell went shopping at the Walmart on the morning of January the 26th. Police say Odell then sat in his truck until the female victim parked her car next to his truck. Odell then moved his truck to a different parking spot, got out, and placed two rolled up pieces of paper under the woman's door handle.
Were they small pieces of paper?
Those papers.
Real small.
Okay. Those papers had pictures of his erect penis with hardware around his genitals.
Oh, boy.
I don't know what that means by hardware.
Hardware? Like nuts and bolts?
I think it's probably one of those, like, you know, that helped you sustain an erection for a longer period of time.
Oh, thank you.
Or maybe piercings.
The Prince Albert.
So,
Prince
Albert, yeah. Odell admitted to police that he took two pictures of his erect penis and placed them under the door handle of the victim's car. A police spokesman said, quote, Timothy admitted to parking in an area and watching the victim return to her vehicle and see the pictures of his erect penis. He admitted he did this for the thrill of it and to see the victim's reaction.
Unbelievable. What the hell is wrong with these people?
The victim told police she didn't ask for the pictures and was afraid the suspect was stalking her. Odell was charged with distribution of pornographic material, a third-degree felony in the state
of
Utah.
A felony?
Well, it's Utah. They're very conservative in Utah.
Yeah, that a felony. Be, here in New York, that'd be like
Tuesday.
It's like jaywalking.
Jaywalking.
Jaywalking ticket. Hey, God, come on. Ain't nobody wanting to be see that.
That's terrible.
Well, you know, it did make national news. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah, check it out.
First name is Dee's, last name Nuts.
Dee's 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 Nuts.
Couple more.
Dee's Nuts.
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 Dee's Nuts. Remember that during campaigning?
Yeah, yeah, remember that. Yeah.
I thought it fit there. So there you go. There's your Walmart junk. Unbelievable, but true. Coming up, listener email next on the Electric Radio Show.
First name is Dee's. Last name, Nuts. Dee's.
We're going to have a lot of fun. We got some wonderful people for you.
All you mommies and daddies out there who complain to the radio station, I got something to say to you.
And the first thing you've got to do is say the call letters properly. Okay?
It's an incredible metamorphosis of love and emotion and sensitivity and tenderness and fun and joy and happiness.
Did you know that this show represents help and hope?
The Electric Radio Show.
Today's show is brought to you by people who called into work saying they were sick. I was going to call in sick today, but I had to read this.
Well, I get up real early and turn on my radio. Listen to the whole crew on the Electric Radio Show. They're so funny and it's all free. They make me laugh so hard they make me have to pee.
It's the Electric Radio Show. A little slow in the booth there. That's all right. Acceptable.
They've been doing pretty good.
Time to dip into the mailbag. Pull out this gem from Hannah in Eureka, California. Dear Studio ERS, I'm 36 and Carl, my significant other, is 44. We aren't married, but have been living together for 5 years, and I thought we were in a committed relationship. A friend of mine uses a dating site, and she told me that she found a profile with Carl's picture, and he called himself Carlo.
Oh, boy.
I went on, and sure enough, there was his profile. He claimed to be single and looking for a serious relationship. Hmm. When I confronted Carl, or Carlo, he said it was just a joke. He wanted to see if he can get any responses and that he would never have gone on any dates, but he just chatted with a few ladies. Now, I'm not buying this, though, because this is a dating site you have to pay for.
Oh, boy.
Now I'm starting to think all those nights that he claimed to be working late that he was out on dates. Am I not enough for him? Why is he doing this? I'm very hurt, and I don't know what to do. Hannah in Eureka, California.
Wow.
I'm going last because I think this is a damn no-brainer.
And I think it's a no-brainer, too. Yeah,
Dee Lite.
I'm the same way.
What do you think?
Hannah, come on. Did you really need to write to us to...
Come on. What are you, Hannah freaking Montana? You know what's going on.
I mean, if this was one of those free sites, I could kind of give him a pass, but... The fact that he's got to pay to use this site, that should tell you right there.
So what does she do?
You got to dump his ass.
Wow.
I agree with her.
D-H-A.
Yep.
Dump his ass.
Yeah.
To the left.
It's totally disrespectful. The whole thing is disrespectful. I mean, if you're living with somebody for 5 years, okay, even if there's no wedding ring involved, you're supposedly committed, you shouldn't be on dating sites.
Okay.
And when she asked him, he should have just admitted he did it.
Yeah, well.
You know, I mean, it you know, that is, Dee Lite is absolutely correct.
You got a DHA from Dee Lite.
Yeah, and she's absolutely correct. It is disrespectful. It's so disrespectful to do that. And then when you get confronted with it, oh, it's a joke, or is that? And, you know, they always say there's a lot of truth in joking, right?
Yeah.
Well, so, you know, with him doing that was just, it was way wrong. And Eureka, well, you know, Eureka is behind right out of the door.
The fact that he changed his name to Carlo, I mean, that's...
Carlo.
It's like, well, what's his name, that doof from New York City?
Carlos Danger.
Yeah, Anthony Weiner.
Yeah.
Anthony, like, Weiner wasn't stupid enough, man, so he's got to change his name to Carlos Danger. Weiner.
Wow. Just
the name fits.
Give Troop the boot.
So you're DHA for Carlo.
Absolutely.
Dump his ass.
Absolutely.
I am a resounding dump his ass. Look, Hannah, come on. You can't be this naive. He's paying for the website. even if it was for free.
Yeah, I would have a problem with it even if it was
for
free.
Hell damn,
but
yeah.
Yeah.
There's no way. No way. He said he was working late. Bull crap.
That's right.
Bull. You could tell Carlos Danger, Anthony Weiner, whoever you're seeing, to kiss your rosy red behind.
You're not buying it.
You ain't buying it, and dump his ass.
Adiosito, Carlosito.
That's it. That's it. With the cleaning staff.
That's right. There you go.
You non-citizen, build that wall.
Wow.
Build a wall around Carlo and dump his ass.
That's right.
So there you go, Hannah. Come on, move on with your life, sweetheart. You're only 36, man.
Seriously.
You are so young, believe me. You are far from over the hill, and I'm sure you can find somebody that will be committed to a relationship, and it ain't Carlo.
And no rebounds.
No rebound dating. Hugh will get into that coming up in the Zodiac Maniac
that's
segment,
right.
So that's
no
coming
rebound.
Up as well. You got to listen to her email. You want to send it off to us, studioers@gmail.com. Subject line, listener email. Coming up, he's ready to go. He's ready to blow his magic flute. He's got his magic stick. He's ready to give you the Zodiac for the week. Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Maniac, is on the way on the Electric Radio Show.
Look, I'm sick and I need to see a doctor.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, Ferris, how's your bod? Oh my God, you're dying?
Uh-oh.
Is it serious?
I don't know. I hope not. I think I may need a kidney transplant.
Are you upset?
Excuse me.
Think you'll be alive this weekend?
Yeah, I'd say I will.
Great, maybe I'll see ya. Bye.
If you don't want to go into work, don't. Call them. It's a sick day. They're going to give you the day off. You can lie. I do, and I would call in and be like, hey, what's up? It's me. It's Sean. I'm not going to make it into work today. Roar! I'm sorry. I got the roars. Wow, wow, wow! Oh, no, I'm a bobcat. Or this. This will get you off for like a month straight if you need it. Jim. Hey, what's up? It's me and Sean. I'm not going to make it work. Sorry, that's embarrassing. I can't. I'm sorry. I got the beatboxes. It's pretty bad. And the scratches too. It's like I got the. Your whole crew is whack. I don't even know what I'm gonna say next. I can't even finish a sentence.
Are you done with your day-to-day drudgery? Tired of a 9-to-5 salt mine?
My job, don't get me started on, because it really annoys me.
Take this job and shove it.
Take this job and shove it.
Work, 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 work. It's a me heavy work, 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 work.
I wish I had a job that I could just leave.
The Gallup survey estimates that workers who are actively disengaged are just going through the motions.
Why don't you put down your ginger ale and red book and get to work?
Go back to work.
Work, 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 work. It's a me heavy work, 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 work.
Working for the weekend.
Can't wait till Friday.
We are going to have so much fun this weekend.
Work, 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 work. It's a me heavy work, 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 work. You see me do me da 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 da. It's something better. Work, 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 work.
Happy Friday. Hope you have a great weekend.
Oh, it's Friday. We're heading into the weekend.
This is gonna be awesome.
Yeah. This sucks. Being here sucks. This work sucks.
It's a hard job, but then again, I'm a hard man.
She's got one of those meaningless executive jobs in show business.
All right, let's go back to work here.
I don't work well with other people.
A job is where people work.
And I've been taking care of business every day. Taking care of business every way. I've been taking care of business. It's all right. Taking care of business and working overtime.
Back to work.
Time to go to work, maybe.
Oh, he's a real workaholic. Yeah, you mentioned work, he gets drunk.
On the radio, on the way to work.
Hey, what's the idea, Fred? We gotta get to work.
Hey, look, you, just shut your pie hole and keep working.
It's like working with a monkey.
That's not a job, it's a waste of time.
Let's go to work.
Taking care of business. We be taking care of business.
What could possibly be funny about fart noises?
Everything.
Ew, gross.
You know what else is gross?
Fart in your general direction.
Now, is it just me, or have you guys heard a strange sound?
Did you just fart? Ew.
I've heard of strange things, but not in a porta potty on a golf course.
The sexiest thing a woman could do for a man is learn to love his gas.
I'm passing gas like a NASCAR pit crew.
Love it!
In other news,
you don't have to show you're strange to get attention.
Gentlemen, that was a fart.
I don't want to hear one more fart out of you. Is that clear?
It's the Electric Radio Show.
Woo! Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right.
I love that top of the hour open. I play it a lot. I play it a lot.
I know you do.
Hey, I built that, man. That's right, Barack. I built that. Just want to let you know. I did build that. Coming up in just a few minutes, I'm going to give you guys some love with social shout-outs. Thanks so much for the love on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. But straight ahead, he's all ready to go. He's got his magic flute and stick. He'll give you the astrology for the week. Sacred Owl is next, the Zodiac Maniac, on the Electric Radio Show.
Could you rub my butt? I sat on it so much it's a little sore.
You already know what it is. I'm
telling you. You're listening to the Electric Radio Show.
On air and turn it up online. Watch it,
Pam. TheElectricRadioShow.com.
Come join the party.
Feel the power.
It's the Electric Radio Show. There he is. Nobody plays a flute like this man. Nobody has a magic stick like this man. Nobody can give astrology like this man. Sacred Owl, the Zodiac Maniac.
And a beautiful stick it is.
Yes, it is. Oh, look at that. All right, put it away now.
All right, buddy.
Go back to Walmart junk.
Oh, wow, yeah. We don't want that to
don't
happen.
Leave a picture of it under Dee Lite's door handle.
Yeah, please.
I'll do it.
No. Hey. Well, the sun is in Aquarius up to the end of this week. So, you know, as you're doing that, it's going to shift into Pisces. So enjoying this cycle, going out of Aquarius, we're motivated by our hunger for knowledge and experience and originality. But when it gets into Pisces, we're guided by altruistic feelings. They were less motivated to do things or to feel, to imagine and dream. So be very mindful that if you feel somewhat almost depressed, it's because the energy of the sun and the moon is working you, and it's going to pick up in a couple of weeks. But also, we have this thing coming in March that is Jack's transition.
Oh, geez.
Okay, but, you know, we got a couple
of weeks. For those of you just joining the show, that's Mercury in retrograde.
Yes, yes. It's
when is it coming?
Well, it's supposed to come. It's coming in March.
Do we know when?
Yeah, I do know when.
Is it around my freaking birthday?
It is absolutely, probably, when's your birthday again?
March 7th.
That's right. It's going to be a couple of days after that.
Well, suck my Mercury in retrograde. Okay.
Well, you know, it's not that bad, though. I mean, this one probably will work for you because it's during your birthday transit. And so it's probably going to be also in the sign of Pisces. I have to check that out to make sure. But with Pisces coming, it's a universal time to understand that you have this natural wisdom about you. So allow that energy to work for you during this transition when the sun's leaving Aquarius and going into Pisces. And then you'll be prepared to deal with Mercury in retrograde when it comes in February. Oh, March, I mean. Jeez. Where am I at?
I don't know.
I know, right?
I'm going to build a wall around this report.
I'm telling you. Well, so Venus forms a sextile with Neptune.
And that's Venus with a V.
Venus with a V forms a sextile with Neptune, and it aligns with Saturn on Sunday, Monday, and during the week. And so make sure that your imagination is attuned to the world of beauty and romance. So understand that a lot of things you're going to look at and fall in love with, it's just a temporary thing. Don't go out there and divorce your family just to get to this person that you think you love, because it's only for a minute. And then when you
it's
when
like she, the definition of my life.
Yeah.
But also, you know, and then during the end of the week, you're going to be feeling stuck in this situation because it's only going to happen for 2 days, and then all of a sudden you're going to say, what am I doing?
Dee Lite, you should write a book called Got a Minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, exactly. You know, and so, and then that leads us to the next thing, that sun sextiles Uranus.
Oh!
Yes!
Ouch!
Yes!
Preparation H for that.
Yes, we do. So it's like adapting to new circumstances, ideas, and unfamiliar situations. So it's a good time to join any kind of organizations or any groups if you want to be a part of something. It's also a great time, and as crazy as this, if you have an addiction, it's a great time to get rid of it.
No, okay.
You'll have the strength and the fortitude to go ahead and drop whatever habits that you have. And if it's food, money, women, whatever it is, you'll be able to drop it and enjoy. Now, mind you, social events will be in heightened because when you drop it, you'll be able to go to meetings, meet people, and really start all over again. Okay, the solution and problems are now in a very positive way. So now be really careful about your flexibility because you're going to feel limited, but you're actually very flexible, but you have to force the energy to do that, okay?
Mm.
Now, Mercury squares Jupiter, which is information overload. So that means that you're going to get all this information because Jupiter is the biggest planet in the world and Mercury is about communication and information. And because it's squaring Jupiter, it's going to cause an irritation. So you're going to have all this information and not know what the hell to do with it.
Did you really just say Jupiter is the biggest planet in the world?
I just said that, didn't
I? What's wrong with that?
No, because it's supposed to be in the solar system. It's okay.
Jupiter's the biggest planet in the world.
Yes, it is.
What's wrong with that?
Because Jupiter's not part of our world, Dodo.
Yeah, it's part of...
I don't like space. I told you, I don't like space.
Even though you're a cadet.
You know, well, I got to tell you a story about that, though. But, you know, but the thing is that you want to really be cool with this energy being that way. That way you don't jump to conclusions and you don't overthink and overprocess this whole thing and create problems for yourself that you don't want to even want to deal with. Okay. Now, Chiron enters Aries this week, and is going to stay there till the year 2027.
Damn.
Wait, right. Who's Chiron?
Yeah. Chiron is a comet.
And he's overstaying his damn welcome.
Yeah, it's a comet that goes around influencing magnetically all the planets and stuff. So every time it goes through a planet or a sign, it kind of pulls energy through it. And Chiron represents like different sensitivities, being overly emotional. So you have to really be mindful when Chiron goes through.
Yeah, Chiron, know your role,
Jabroni. So for 8 years, we've got to be mindful of this?
No. Yeah. It enters Aries, and it's going to be in Aries for 8 years. So the people who have Aries, it's going to be...
Is it good for Aries or bad for Aries?
It's really, really good for Aries.
All right. So yeah, Aries, so if you're out there and you're listening, you could have a wonderful 8 years coming.
I'm excited because I'm Aries. So.
Oh, really?
It's going right into my sign.
Well, then come over here and touch my Chiron.
Well, you know, maybe later, okay?
All right.
All right. So as it enters that, it's going to allow you to daydream. And you're actually going to start... It started last night. Like, I went and played.
Oh, man, I bet it did.
Yeah, because I went and I touched the lotto machine and I won like $150. No, it was $200 I won.
Nice.
So I was like, okay, this is really good. So we're going in a good place.
All right, we're going to the casino.
You know what? That might be a really, really good idea. So, you know, just be mindful that you're going to get a lot of epiphanies in this time. So ride high on them. Listen to them. Allow them to guide you. And allow them to be the best friend that you ever had. Your information is your power, especially in this astrology transit this week. And then Nancy Russo of Queens Village, New York, asked about Sagittarius.
All right. Sag.
Take your time before you attempt to put anything into place with any sort of finality because it will be easy to overlook something important. Mm. That's that Chiron thing. Mm. You are in a good position to see clearly the level of commitment you can handle effectively and sort out the time that it would take to do it. What can be afforded financially will come into fruition. So if you want to go buy a new car or a new house and that, do it, but please do it before Mercury in retrograde.
All right. Sacred L, the Zodiac Maniac.
Thank
there you go.
All right.
Give me the bell for that one.
Yes.
All right, Q, so let me ask you this.
Fire away.
So at the top of the show, I said that I have this birthday fundraiser going on my Facebook page,
right.
facebook.com/TheRealJackHammer. It's going through the 15th of March.
Right.
What do you see? Is this going to be good?
It's going to be very good.
All right.
Very, very good for you.
because Chiron doesn't visit my astrological sign. I get the comet Moron that visits my astrological sign.
Well, you know, Moron, though, has some money, so you'll be okay. It'll definitely work. But as for your birthday and everything like that, I have a surprise report for your birthday.
All right. Awesome. We'll deal with that before the end of the show?
Absolutely.
All right, we'll deal with it at the end of the show.
How about that?
All right, because it's probably going to make me cry. And when it comes to Bridget and Sonny, I cry easy.
Right.
So we'll wait to the end of the show.
How about we do that?
All right, we'll do that. Coming up in just a little bit, we're going to give you love for loving us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Social shout-outs on the way on The Electric Radio Show.
We love this show.
Well, maybe you're used to it, but for me, it was kind of a surprise.
The Electric Radio Show.
Bernie Sanders doing ordinary things.
I want to tell you, I was attacked by two men. One of them I did not know. The other was Elizabeth Warren. One of them had a rope, and attached was a bar of soap. One of them poured something on my head. I think it was hazelnut. And that is not the way you get rid of me. Howard Schultz.
This has been Bernie Sanders doing ordinary things.
It's the Electric Radio Show. Time to give you a little bit of love for loving us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. It's the social shout-outs portion of the show. My timing is perfect. I just can't dance.
No, you
My radio
can't.
Timing is awesome. My dance timing sucks. Let's start with Facebook. In Red Hook, New York, we have Donald Tremaine. In Cincinnati, Ohio, big shout out to Brian Fielding. And in Corpus Christi, Texas, Brooke McConnell. Thank you so much.
All right.
Thanks for the love on Facebook. Flying on over to Twitter from Seattle, Washington, we have Jeremiah Pletcher in Orlando, Florida. Have been there in so long, I gotta go back to Florida. We have Crowd Pleasers Incorporated. And from Saugerties, New York, we have Dave Canyon. So thank you, Dave.
Okay.
Thanks, everybody on Twitter. And my favorite social media, Instagram, from New York, New York, we have Jake Garay. In Central Florida, we have Tomasano's Pizza. And we have Aries Cigars in London, England. Thank you so much.
All right. And I like it. Aries Cigar.
I was going to say, wouldn't you love to go sit in London, England right now and have a cigar?
I would.
Dee Lite.
London's one of my favorite cities in the whole world.
But would you have a cigar with us?
I don't smoke.
I know you don't smoke, but I know plenty of women that don't smoke that do, however.
Yeah, I've never
will puff a cigar.
I've never tried a cigar. I don't really think it's something that
some of them are really tasty.
Me,
I love my wife's uncle calls them a gum wrapper cigar. I love those, which is a very sweet tasting cigar. I'm not really aficionado of cigars, but I do like what I like. And I have, when I was traveling the Comic-Con circuit, we would go and visit a cigar bar if it was close, a real nice one, have a nice glass of like brandy or cognac with a nice cigar. Man, nothing like it. It's heaven. It really is heaven. If you guys want to get a social shout out, it's simple. All you got to do is go to theelectricradioshow.com. All of our stuff is there. Click like, love, share. Who knows? You might be getting a shout out coming up on the next Electric Radio Show. All right, we're going to close things up in a few minutes. And I guess Sacred Owl is going to give me a current total on the Jackhammer birthday fundraiser, which is to benefit Take Me Home Pet Rescue in Highland, New York. And that is a total as of the recording of this show. And I'm telling you, I want to put it way, way, way over the top. I want to go way over the top with this. So Facebook.com/TheRealJackhammer. And it's right there. It's my birthday fundraiser. You don't have, listen, there's predetermined values you can contribute. And there it says other. Give what you can.
Right.
Give what you can. It's a great organization, and they're saving animals from being euthanized and abused and all this other stuff.
And the total has moved.
Oh, it's moved again?
Yes, it has.
Oh, my God. All right. And by the way, I set a reasonable total at like $200.
You're going to have to adjust it.
All right. So that's coming up on the... I was almost said on the next Electric Radio. See, you got me all... knocked up. It's coming up next on the Electric Radio Show. Stick around.
All right. Take care now.
How could you let them go?
Most of this country
probably wants him to go away.
There's no sense getting all riled up every time a bunch of idiots give you a hard time.
Take care now.
Mommy, could we please talk about this later?
Bye-bye then.
In the end, the universe tends to unfold as it should.
Bye-bye, bye-bye, my baby, bye-bye.
We're ending the show. And we hope you enjoyed it very much. Many things transpired here today, and we hope you stick around for whoever's next, because they're really, really, really good as well.
All right, big finish.
Show's over, folks.
That's it. Go home, everybody. None of this ever happened.
Well, kids, that's our show for today. And now, in the words of Mr. Cole Porter...
All right, that's going to do it.
All right.
All right. All right. First off, Q wants to give a reading. Now, what do you want to do?
I just want to give you a real quick insight to your birthday.
Into my birthday.
And Mercury retrograde real quick.
All right. The birthday fundraiser is going on right now for Take Me Home Pet Rescue in Highland, New York. I started it up now. My birthday is not actually until March 7th.
Right.
And I have the fundraiser going for 8 days after my birthday. It's going till the 15th. All right. So what do you want to say?
Well, your fundraiser is at 50%.
I'm already at 50%. Now, my goal was $200. So we're already at $100.
There you go.
At the time of this recording.
That's right.
All right. So what are you thinking, man?
Well, I'm also saying to you that with the Pisces and Mercury and retrograde thing for you, here's a very beautiful thing. It said, when I read it, I almost got very emotional for you.
All right.
And it said that the fishes of Pisces are swimming in the ocean of collective conscious unconsciousness for those who are loved and have passed on for you.
All right. So what does that mean?
Your loved ones who have passed on have collected themselves together to bring you great fortune. This Mercury in retrograde is actually an energy that's going to boost your fortune, your finances, and your abundance. And guess who's running the show?
Who's running the show?
The loved ones that passed away. Especially the most recent one.
Oh. My Bridget.
Yes. Because it says that the death of a loved one will bring in great fortune as they are running the bar.
That would be her too, man.
Yeah, because she loved you to death.
Yeah.
And when I saw that, most retrogrades have been horrible.
Yeah.
This one is saying
like my phone goes on fire.
Yeah, well, yeah, so does mine. But this one is saying that, you know, this retrograde is bringing you great fortune. So,
right.
You know, but, you know, when you do hit it, you know, I want a trip to Hawaii, okay?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's going to be like that.
Yeah, it's like that.
I want that money for Take Me Home. I want them to go out and gather up as many dogs. And it's not just dogs, by the way. It's dogs and cats. They do everything. These animals that are displaced, abused, set to be euthanized.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? I'm going to just go to facebook.com/TheRealJackHammer. That's where you can make the donation. And then you'll be able to find the Facebook page of Take Me Home Pet Rescue. I'm totally in love with what they do.
Well, and I am too, but I'm also saying that you're going to have enough fortune, according to this, afterwards to take care of everything.
All right. Well, that's what I'm looking for. I just want to take care of animals. That's all I want to do. And I'm doing this in memory of my two dogs, Bridget and Sonny. So give whatever you can. There's no amount too small to give. Take Me Home Pet Rescue, Highland, New York. And as always, we want to thank you guys. We love you guys for tuning in each and every week. And our first responders, our police, fire, EMS dispatchers, thank you for what you do for our local community so everybody can go about their daily lives in safety and peace and happiness. And to the greatest fighting force this world has ever known, the Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard, Thank you for what you do for us and others around this great planet of ours to keep everybody safe from tyranny, oppression, and terrorism. Everybody take care, be well, have a great week. Relax. We're back here in a little over 6 days with another Electric Radio Show.
Take care. God bless.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you to all our troops. God bless America.
Here to perform our national anthem, United States Navy veteran and national recording artist, Dave Bray, USA.